Hello guys, welcome to TechCovery IT Solutions, and in today's video I'm going to show you how to solve the problem of no bootable device found. So actually let me tell you about this laptop. It's a Dell Latitude, and I've already plugged in a hard drive which has an operating system already, and the operating system is installed at UEFI mode. So now when I plugged in the hard drive and I'm trying to boot it from that hard drive, it's not working. Let's say when I restart the laptop, it will come up with there is no bootable device found. Up to this part it will go well, and after that it will, you know, search for the operating system, and it's gonna come up with the solution that there is no bootable device found. So yeah, but you can see the error message, but I'm 100% sure that there is a bootable device. So you have to restart your machine, and when you get this logo, you should know what's the key to get into the BIOS setup. In this one it's a Dell, so it's F2. So you have to find that which laptop are you using and how, like, the key to get to the BIOS. Now when you are here in the BIOS, there are multiple options. Go to boot sequences, and boot sequences, search for something like, you know, legacy and UEFI. If you can see in here, it's selected as in legacy, and I already told you that the hard drive I plugged in on this laptop, which has the operating system, and the operating system were installed as an UEFI, not as a legacy system. So now the computer is trying to read the hard drive as a legacy, but the hard drive is not there as a legacy, it's with UEFI. So if I select UEFI, it's giving me two options, like from where should I it be booting the operating system, or window boot manager. Good. This is UEFI, this is my hard drive, so I have to click on this and make it first, and now my computer will first go and boot from the hard drive, which is UEFI, and will be good. Just exit it, and I've already saved it. You have to just save it, just keep that in mind, and now it will boot up again, and let's see if it come up with the operating system now. Yes, here we go. So that's the problem. Just keep in mind, the keys to get into the BIOS might be different. Like in this case it's F2 because it's Dell. In your case it should be different. And another thing, the keys and the way to deal with the BIOS might be different, but you have to just look for something like legacy and UEFI. If it's legacy, select UEFI, and if that didn't work, and if it is already UEFI, select legacy, and it will work. Like one of those will work 100%. Thank you very much for watching this video, and if it helps, please like it and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye.